Whoa, we're pulling? What's up? It's Nipro from Medicheck Pool, and this is our official boss guide for the Tarragrue on Normal and Heroic. Yeah, the Tarragrue from Torghast. It's the first boss of the raid, and you get to have actual animal powers from Torghast while fighting this thing. So, before killing the boss, you can kill four big trash can looking mobs that each drop a choice of random animal powers. Unfortunately, they're not the fun class-specific powers, just generic ones, but some of them are actually crazy strong. There's way too many to list in the video, so we'll put a link in the description with all of the abilities if you want to check them out. However, we do have some big recommendations. Number one, definitely don't take the one that makes you big and knocks people around. You'll definitely kill a few allies with this one, or at least you'll make them super mad. Number two, definitely don't take the one that stuns everyone around you when you die. This will also make people mad at you. And number three, definitely have at least one person in the raid take the one that makes you immune to stun and fear effects. This will entirely negate the deadliest mechanic in the fight if you use it right. All the other powers are just varying shades of good, so just have fun with them. Now for the actual strategy of the fight. First of all, this is definitely a Bloodlust on pull boss, despite it having sort of an enrage we'll talk about later. The deadliest mechanic, as we mentioned, is Chains of Eternity, which marks a random player and throws a chain at them after a few seconds. This chain can be intercepted by standing between the boss and the marked player, but whoever gets hit will be stunned and get one-shot by the boss. The only way to avoid this one-shot is by immuning the stun, which you can do with regular immunities or with that animal power we mentioned earlier. If someone has this power, they can just soak the chain cast by standing between the boss and the marked player. Otherwise, you'll have to rotate immunities and that can get messy. All of the other mechanics are more straightforward to deal with. The tanks have a taunt swap after every overpower, which stuns and increases physical damage taken for a little bit. There's a dispellable debuff that goes out on a bunch of random players, which fears everyone standing close to those players, so everyone should stay a little spread out to avoid fearing each other. Dispel any players that get feared, as well as players that need to move for other mechanics in the fight. The boss will cast an enrage that needs to be immediately removed by druids, hunters, and rogues. There's also an anima power that slowly removes the stacks of enrage, but it's pretty damn slow. When the boss disappears and the room gets dark, quickly move to each safe spot until he's active again. And on heroic, you'll need to soak these circles that spawn around the room. There's three different kinds that each give you a different debuff, and they need to be soaked quickly because otherwise each debuff is applied to the entire raid. Everyone except for the tanks should try to soak the gray ones because they'll increase your physical damage taken. Pretty much only the tanks should soak the purple ones because they increase your magical damage taken, and anyone can soak the red ones because they give you a dot. Oh, and the last thing, when the boss gets to 10% health, it removes everyone's animal powers and goes berserk, just running around one-shotting people. It's pretty wild to see, but if you get to that part of the fight with plenty of people alive, you'll be fine. Probably. Alright, so quick recap. Don't take the animal powers that screw over your allies, and make sure that at least one person takes the stun immunity one. Intercept the chain cast with the stun immunity animal power or rotate class immunities. Stay spread out to prevent fears. Tanks taunt swap after every overpower. Remove the enrage as soon as possible. Run to the safe spots when the room gets dark. And on heroic, soak the debuff circles. And that's pretty much it. You can find our written version of these guides on Icy Veins linked below. Thanks again to all of our supporters on Patreon for making these guides possible. Like, subscribe, and join our Discord to keep up with everything Ready, Check, Pull. Peace.